Ladies and gentlemen, hi, I'm Cameron Maslavi Jones, the official team spokesperson for Zing Revolution. What if you could actually be in the comics? Now you can. Zing Revolution and Marvel Comics invite you to crash the comics, save the universe. Go to zingrevolution.com/marvel to learn more. Crash the comics, save the universe. Go to zingrevolution.com/marvel to learn more.
I'm Tamara Krinsky.
And I'm Andrea Fetchko.
And we are here. You are watching Marvel Live. We are at the world premiere of Captain America, the Winter Soldier, brought to you by Zing Revolution, streaming on Yahoo.
This is amazing right now. We are in the middle of Hollywood. We have actually shut down Hollywood Boulevard. The stars have already started to arrive here on the red carpet. And this is amazing because, as Tamara said, it is the world premiere. This is the first time the actors are all coming together and we'll be able to see it in the historic El Capitan Theater.
That's right. And Hollywood Boulevard is packed. There are fans that have been lining the streets. You can probably hear them screaming a little bit. We can definitely hear them. They've been here since early this morning so that they can get a glimpse of some of their favorite stars.
And everyone's going to be here. Of course, Captain America, Chris Evans, Scarlett Johansson, Samuel L. Jackson, everyone's making an appearance, as well as some new faces.
Mm-hmm. And you're gonna get to see them all, whatever device you're watching on, as we stream live on Yahoo. Very excited about that. We're gonna see some new faces like Emily Van Camp as Agent 13, and of course, Anthony Mackie as the Falcon.
Yes, he's amazing in this film. And as the stars come up and speak to Tamara in an interview, you can be involved in this conversation using the hashtag #CapWorldPremiere.
That's
in sync,
right.
I like that.
You can also follow everything Captain America with the official Twitter account at Captain America, or like us on Facebook at facebook.com/Captain America.
This is going to be a really amazing red carpet. You know, everyone's coming here, but this is an incredible film. This is the biggest action film Marvel has done yet, which is saying a lot.
Which is saying quite a lot. And we are going to cover all the action on this carpet from beginning to end. We've got the thing covered with cameras, including a fashion cam, which is you'll be stationed with at the arrivals area.
Exactly.
And we've got the main stage here where we'll be interviewing Marvel stars and execs. And we've got a jib, which is going to give you a bird's eye view of this entire carpet so that you can see how really, really huge it is.
And we'll be streaming live until about 7:15, 7:20 tonight. And you want to stay till the end because we actually have an exclusive clip coming to you at the very end of the live stream. It's never been seen before. It gives you a showing of what Captain America and a few of his friends can do.
Because you know Marvel, they always say something good for the very end.
Exactly. So we got to see the movie a few nights ago. What was your favorite part? What was the thing that really looked?
Well, you know, I have to say overall my favorite thing is the fact that they have really made an incredible thriller.
Yes, this is a different film than anything Marvel has ever done before. It's pretty much they described it as one part spy thriller conspiracy theory and then the other part superhero action adventure film.
And you know, we get to see the team up of Captain America and Natasha Romanoff, Black Widow, and they have some great moments on screen together.
And you really feel that, you know, this is post the Marvel's The Avengers, and they're friends here, they've been working side by side, and what's really interesting is that actually Chris Evans and Scarlett Johansson, this is their fourth film together, so that you can really believe that they're friends and they know everything about each other.
That's right, it's going to be fun to talk to them about that on the carpet tonight. Chris Evans and Anthony Mackie have also worked together, and Anthony Mackie and Samuel L. Jackson have also worked together before.
And so, even crazier, Robert Redford and Scarlett Johansson last worked together when she was 12 years old on The Horse Whisperer.
Okay, can we just pause for a second? Robert Redford, Marvel movie, conspiracy movie. How amazing is that?
And because it was a conspiracy theory, the directors, Anthony and Joe Russo, were like, Robert Redford has to be on here because he's iconic in those spy thriller movies, and to actually get him,
incredible,
is amazing. We're so good.
We're gonna give you guys a little sneak peek of just what you have in store in this fantastic movie.
Get me off the grid now!
They call him the Winter Soldier.
Explain how this country is expected to maintain its national security now that he has laid waste to our intelligence agency.
The price of freedom is high, and it's a price I'm willing to pay.
All right, Cap, I'm in.
The world is a vulnerable place. But we're the best qualified to defend it.
Damn right. I thought you said you were a pilot.
I never said pilot.
Only in theaters April 4th.
All right, so just to give you guys an idea of where we are live on Hollywood Boulevard. The El Capitan Theater is behind me, which is the historic theater where many of the Marvel movies have had their premiere. You can hear the fans roaring in the distance. Andrea has gone down to the limo area to watch the arrivals. By the way, there are some incredible vehicles in this movie. Samuel L. Jackson, Nick Fury, gets a really tricked-out vehicle that he has some extra special features, and I think you guys are going to really enjoy seeing that. And of course, you've got Captain America riding in his motorcycle. So we'll see how they're going to arrive on the carpet today. You can see this thing stretches all the way down the block, and we're just waiting for some stars to arrive, and we will begin talking to them. You can see the carpet slowly filling up. The fans have been waiting. And here we are. And so it's getting a little bit chilly here, but that is okay. That's kind of appropriate for the Winter Soldier. One of the most exciting things about this film is the Winter Soldier storyline. It was created by Ed Brubaker in 2005, and we've been waiting to see how exactly this is going to play out on screen. So for Marvel fans, you've got a lot of really exciting things. Sebastian Stan plays the Winter Soldier, and he doesn't say a lot, but when his face is finally revealed, it's a pretty amazing moment, and he really does a lot in giving you some insight into what he's thinking about. Now, as you can see, the fans people are starting to sign things, and they have been waiting. They've all brought props. I've seen a whole bunch of Captain America shields, which is pretty exciting. He does use, in this film, we do use the iconic round shield. As you know, Captain America, number one, started off with the kite-shaped shield, but this film has the round shield. We also get to see Captain America in a new suit. As we mentioned, this is a conspiracy thriller, and part of the setup of the film is that Captain America, Steve Rogers, is living peacefully in D.C. when he's not off working on S.H.I.E.L.D. missions, and most of these missions are indeed stealth missions. So they have designed a new stealth suit for him. It's navy blue with a little bit of silver. It's a little bit more understated. It actually has a Kevlar ballistics component to it, so it helps protect him a little bit better against some of the modern elements, and that's one of the cool things that will be revealed in this film. We are now starting to have some of the stars come down the carpet, including Bernard White. He is part of the council, so we're going to be talking to him in just a moment or two. The council, of course, you could describe them as Nick Fury's bosses. It always seems like Nick Fury's in charge, but he does actually have people to answer to. We are looking forward to talking to him about what it's been like to answer to his bosses. So come on over, please. Hello. All right. Hi. So we are talking to Marvel fans. We're streaming live on Yahoo. So introduce yourself and say hello.
My name is Bernard White. I play the character of Indian Councilman Nagendra Singh, part of the World Security Council, with Alan Dale, Chin Han, Jenny Agutter, and Robert Redford. You've heard of Robert Redford.
Oh, yeah, that guy. What was it like to hang out and act with Robert Redford?
It's like you're hanging out with the history of cinema, including Paul Newman. And he's an amazing guy. He sits on the set. He doesn't go back to his trailer. Reads the New York Times from cover to cover every day. Amazing guy.
And for you, I mean, this is an immense red carpet. What's it like to be here at the premiere of a Marvel movie?
It's an honor. It's a privilege. It's the idea of an immigrant from Sri Lanka, where I was born, who rode steerage class on the Queen Mary and is now at the Captain America premiere as an actor in the film. I'm honored, thrilled, grateful, humbled, and very appreciative.
Well, we are very glad that you're here. So, question for you.
Yes.
If you could have Cap's shield or Falcon's wings, which would you choose?
Well, I'm going to go with the shield. Oh, no, come on. Wings. Who doesn't want to fly?
Got it. And did you read comics growing up at all?
I didn't, but when I got this part, I started reading them, and so I know a little.
Yeah.
Yeah. I read Archie and whatnot.
Really?
You know, the sissy comics. I didn't, you know.
Well, you're kicking butt now, so.
Kicking butt now as part of the World Security Council.
Great. Well, thank you so much for stopping
thank
to talk with us.
Thank you for having me. Thank
you. Okay, take care. We have just gotten word that Samuel L. Jackson has arrived. We cannot wait to talk to him about his latest adventures as Nick Fury. He is really pivotal in this movie. This movie is a S.H.I.E.L.D. movie, so of course we get to see a lot more of what he's doing. As you can see, he's making his way down. He looks fantastic in blue, as always. He's so stylish. So we're really looking forward to getting a chance to talk to him. And until we do, we're going to tell you a little bit more about the film. There are some incredible stunts in this movie, and they take place in both very large locations and some very small locations. There's an incredible elevator stunt scene. Now, I'm standing on, you know, a little platform. It's maybe 10 by 10, and that's pretty much the size they had to do this elevator stunt scene in. So there's a lot of hand-to-hand combat, a lot of kicks, a lot of punches, and then eventually they move to bigger locations where Chris Evans gets to show off some of his new modern style fight training. So we're very excited to see that and talk to him about just what he had to do. He used a lot of mixed martial arts this time around, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, Krav Maga, because one of the things they wanted to do was really bring Captain America into the modern age. And they thought training him in some modern fight styles would really help to do that. And we certainly get to see that in action. Now, we can hear people coming down the carpet. We're pretty excited as they make their way. There are also fans lining the buildings up around here. They are up and looking down, checking to see what's going on so that everybody gets a bird's eye view of what's happening. Okay, now we're going to go check in with Andrea to see how things are going in the arrivals area.
Hey, Tamara.
Hey, how's it going down there?
Oh, it's going amazing because Nick Fury just arrived. Woo-hoo! Samuel L. Jackson, head-to-toe blue. He was taking a selfie with all the crowd in the background, uh-huh. which is really amazing. And then one of the new faces, Emily Van Camp, Agent 13, just arrived, and the fans are absolutely going crazy. It's so exciting. But before this all happened, we're so happy that Zing Revolution has been able to sponsor us and bring this red carpet to you guys. And we actually had a very cool interview with the spokesperson Cameron Miles Levy Jones. So let's go to that interview with Tamara and Cameron.
Hey everyone, I'm Tamara and I am here with Cameron, the spokesperson for Zing Revolution. So tell me a little bit about Zing.
Well, what I'm really excited about with Zing is our new custom comics initiative with Marvel. It's this really cool opportunity for people to become their own superhero based off of the Marvel Universe.
How do we do that?
Well, first of all, you take a selfie, you upload it onto our tool, and then you're able to change it and morph it, and you can do all sorts of crazy things to become your own character.
That's awesome.
Then you send it to yourself, and then you're able to put it on tons of different types of products, especially Zing Revolution skins.
Nice. Well, speaking of products, okay, I know you were hoping to see Stan Lee here tonight. Unfortunately, he's not going to be walking the red carpet, but I heard you brought a little giftage for him.
Ashley brought two.
Oop. I love when we get gifts on the red carpet. Okay, so tell me about what we're seeing here.
Well, unfortunately, since Stan couldn't be here, but we know he's here in spirit, in honor of everything that you've done for social justice, Stan, we want to personally thank you with the first product of the Zing Marvel Custom Comics Initiative. So, you know, we have your mug on this mug. Thank you so much. And you know, like you see this hair. Like what kind of stuff would you do with this? What kind of superhero would you make me?
All right, do you have a superhero name for your hair?
I do. Afro Thunder with an A.
Afro Thunder with an A. All right. Afro Thunder, thanks so much for joining us here on the red carpet. Have a great time at the premiere night.
Thank you.
That's really funny, Avril Thunder. You know, when he was saying that he was taking a selfie in order to use the Zing Revolution products, I wonder if that was what Samuel L. Jackson was doing. He's going to be putting himself on a mug later. We shall see. So right now, the arrivals, there's chaos going on. As I said before, Emily Van Camp arrived, and she is actually personally signing autographs for all the fans. She is in an amazing glittery dress, Louboutins, completely decked out for this world premiere. So there's a lot more coming on. There's a lot more Chevy Tahoes coming through, so some stars may be arriving. But right now, Tamara, let's get back to you.
All right. Thanks, Andrea. We are waiting for Georges St. Pierre, who plays Batroc in the film, to make his way down to us. He's one of the baddies. There, he plays a pirate, and we are very excited to talk to him. Streaming live on Yahoo, of course, so all of you will get a chance to hear from him as he tells us what it was like to play a bad guy in a Marvel film and what it was like to do a whole bunch of fight scenes on a boat. This was actually shot on a ship in Long Beach, and the directors have talked about the fact that, sure, they could have, you know, shot on a set and it would have made things a lot easier and they would have had a lot more room. But they said that shooting on an actual ship really helped to ground the reality of what they were doing. So I can't wait to talk to GSP about that. Some of you may know him as a UFC welterweight champion. So we're going to find out how his practical fighting experience translated onto the screen. Because, you know, it's a lot different when you have somebody choreographing your fight. And as you can see right here, we have some of the Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. showing up looking incredible on the red carpet. Everybody always approaches this carpet with a lot of style, so we're looking forward to talking to them about what they're wearing. Check out the gorgeous dress right now that we see happening. It's also getting a little bit chilly here on the carpet, so don't be surprised if you see a couple of stars trying to keep themselves warm. But it is the Winter Soldier, so maybe that's kind of appropriate that there's a chill in the air. I have to say my jewelry was a little bit inspired by the Winter Soldier tonight and his metal arm. You know, I kind of had to give that a little nod. Because that, of course, is one of his great features. As you guys may have seen in some of the clips and previews that have been released so far, there's some really nice interplay. And I'm so excited. All right, we have Georges St. Pierre. Please come over. Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm great. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me here.
Of course. So how does it feel to be joining the Marvel Cinematic Universe?
I mean, all this was my first experience. Yeah. I'm a professional athlete, so this was all new for me. I had to work very hard to learn how to do it, but I had a great help from, I learned from the best here, Chris Evans, all the stunt people, you know, they were very nice with me, and very, very happy to be part of it.
So tell me a little bit about what that process is like, you know, actually going from all of the athletic stuff that you do to having to be choreographed and follow direction while cameras are rolling.
It's very different. Yeah. Like when you fight in a real fight in mixed martial art, in the UFC, you don't telegraph your punches. You do everything short to not telegraph. But in when you fight for the camera, it's the opposite. So you take a big swing and you make everything big and a big telegraph. It's like when let's say you want to punch me, you're not gonna punch me here. You're gonna punch me next for the camera. We'll punch behind my head, so it will look real. So little things like this, they play a lot with the camera and the angle, so it make it look good.
Got it. And, you know, you were shooting on an actual ship. What was that experience like?
Yeah, it was on a ship. It was at night, so it was a lot of fun. I mean, it's my first experience. I didn't know what to expect, but I had a lot of fun.
What was the most surprising thing about it for you, being that it was your first experience?
The most impressive things, I think it was the stunt people. The way they do the scene, they're just amazing, incredible athletic people, and they're always behind everything. So nobody heard about them, but they're so important in the movie. They play, in all action scene, they play the major role. So without them, the movie would not have been possible.
And tell people a little bit about the character you're playing. We are streaming live right now to the Marvel fans who are watching on Yahoo. So tell them a little bit about Batroc.
My character is Georges Batroc. So we have the same name. He speaks French too. He's a French mercenary. He's a bad guy, actually. And he's a martial artist expert. And they say he's an Olympic lifting champion too. So he jumped very high. But he doesn't have superpower. He's a human being, but just very athletic.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for telling us a little bit about your experience. Have a fantastic time tonight. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
All right, everybody, that was GSP, our first interview for the evening and one of many. The scenes on the ship are incredible, and I'm looking forward to talking to the directors about just how everything went down. Shooting at night is pretty crazy, especially when you're dealing with stunts, so a big, big challenge. We have now found out Elizabeth Henstridge and Ian DeCastaker are coming down the carpet. Of course, you may know them from Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Fitz and Simmons. They are the smarties on the show, and we cannot wait to talk to them about what it's like to be part of the Marvel Universe, you know, and the interplay between the two of them. Their rapport on screen is great, and they've had a lot of different adventures. And, you know, when we talked to them in November at Thor the Dark World premiere, they were really just getting started with the show, but it's now been a couple of months. There's a great fan base for the show, so we're going to talk to them about what it's been like, you know, developing their relationship over the course of a whole season. And Joss Whedon, of course, oversees the show, so he's got his hand and everything. Joss, of course, getting a little bit busy right now with Marvel's The Avengers Age of Ultron, which is coming out next summer. We have several movies coming out before then, of course. Guardians of the Galaxy will open this summer, August 1st, followed by Marvel's The Avengers Age of Ultron in May, and then Ant-Man coming in the summer. All right, we're going to go check and see what's happening with Andrea in the arrivals area. Andrea, how's it going down there? Who's coming up next?
Hey, Tamara. Well, there's a lot going on in the arrivals area because Captain America has arrived. Chris Evans is here. He made a big entrance in one of the 2015 Chevy Tahoes. They have a really big role, actually, in Marvel's Captain America, the Winter Soldier. You will see for yourself when you watch the movie, but he just arrived. We actually blocked off the streets specifically for this arrival. He went down to the end of the carpet, and actually now he got out and went back to the fans because there was such a fury, and people actually couldn't figure out who it was because this carpet is so long. The whole street is shut down. There's fans on either side, and so he came back and signed some autographs. And now he's going to be getting to you tomorrow very soon. He's sporting a little scruffy look. He's not clean shaven. He has a little bit of a beard, but he's looking very, very good. And the fans are really, really excited to have Captain America here at the world premiere. Very exciting stuff going on.
Captain America without some Chris Evans showing some fan love. There's a lot of stories about how when they were shooting in Washington, D.C., all the kids would show up and they would have their Captain America shields and their Captain America costumes, and Chris was really, really generous about making time for the kids. He's talked about, you know, how this role really has given him a feeling of responsibility about being a bit of a role model for these kids, you know, that if you sort of don't hold up to that image, then the kids are going to be disappointed, and he really doesn't want to take anything away from what happens on screen. So that's something else that we may be able to talk to him about. We're going to soon be talking with Elizabeth Henstridge and Ian DeCastaker from Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. They are making their way down the carpet, and here they are. Come on, guys. Hello. Hi.
Hi.
Elizabeth and Ian.
Yeah. Hi. How are you?
Good. You look beautiful. How's it going?
Thank you. This is a gorgeous dress. Who are you wearing?
Bajli Mishka.
Very nice. And you, sir, who are you wearing?
You look at your label.
I just somewhere. I just found it in my closet.
You are wearing fabulous. How's that?
Yes, fabulous. I'm wearing clothes for once.
So, question for you guys. We were here in November as the show is just getting started. It's now almost a whole season later. How has this whole journey been for you being part of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, the Marvel TV Universe?
It's been amazing. It's been very exciting, and I feel like we're all learning so much. And It seems like a second ago that we were last speaking to you, but when you look back, so much stuff has happened, and I feel like we've got to experience so much as our characters, and we're loving it.
Yeah.
Still.
Yeah, it's cool. It's nice coming back now as well, sort of since the show's been out. People have had a good taste of it and stuff, and coming to an event and kind of seeing some of the fans of the show and stuff. It's always really nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, I have to say, you know, the relationship between the two of you on the show is so much fun to watch, and I especially love the episode where we go back to the Academy. What was it like shooting that for you guys?
It was great. The writers kind of hinted a couple of times that we might be going back to school, and yeah, we're very excited. It's wonderful. It's always nice to find out more about your character, and so for us it was great. And also, Fitzsimmons were rock stars at the Academy, so that felt pretty good.
Yeah, it's nice, and kind of every every new episode you find out something new about the characters, since this is the start of a new show. So every week we're finding out as well new things about the characters, and that's always good.
Well, great. Well, we cannot wait to see the next couple episodes. Thank you guys so much for taking the talk with us.
Thank you. Good to see you.
Enjoy tonight.
Bye-bye.
Bye. All right, that was Fitz and Simmons. Coming up next, we have Jed Whedon and Marissa Tancher, and they're the executive producers of Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Yep. And they are coming over right here. Hello, Marissa.
Hello, Jed.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
Good to see you.
So this carpet is huge. How does it feel for you guys to be here tonight now that you guys are really, really into almost a full season of the show?
Well, we're just happy to be part of this huge Marvel universe that is so successful, and it's a thing that's very adored and people love it, and we're just happy to be here and see the movie like everybody else.
Yeah, we're happy to play in this universe, so it's fun to see all the characters come out and put on their best.
Well, speaking of playing in this universe, you know, one of the challenges that you guys have is it's a really big interconnected universe. So talk about the writing process a little bit and how that works for you guys.
Well, it's sort of a unique opportunity to be able to play in a universe that's been established in all these huge movies. And so everything, it's sort of our storylines interweave with the stuff that happens in the films. Things that happens in the films inevitably affect stories and events that occur on the show. So the interconnectedness is something that is a fun opportunity for us.
Yeah.
At times it's a little bit of a chore to get everybody on the same page. There's so many moving parts. It's Marvel, it's Monster, so, It's so fun when it clicks, and we've gotten to play with some pretty big toys, I'd say.
You've gotten to play with some great people, too. The episode this week where you had the Asgardian tie-in was really great. So thank you guys for talking with us. We can't wait to see how you guys put together the rest of the puzzle pieces.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Have a good night.
You too. All right. Enjoy the rest. Thank you so much. Okay, coming down the carpet now, we have Ming-Na Wen, who plays Agent May on Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Looking very forward to talking with her. Hello,
hello.
Gorgeous orange. Oh, my gosh.
Thank you. I love your color, too.
Thank you.
Like this royal blue.
Captain America.
Yes, very. Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
I can see that. Yeah.
I mean, we kind of go with themes here if we can.
Okay. Yeah. I guess I went the opposite.
Well, whatever you went, it works. So
Thank you.
Good.
Thank
you're
you.
So it's been, you know, a couple of months since we talked on the carpet for Thor: The Dark World. How's it been now that the series has, you know, almost played out for a full season? How are you feeling about it?
Well, it's really interesting how the hashtag of it's all connected, it's really coming true. And I think when people start to watch our show and then they see Captain America, the Winter Soldier, it's almost such a marriage at this point that you can't watch our television show now without having seen the movie.
Okay, so speaking of marriage, we do have to talk a little bit about what's happening with May and Ward on the show.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, I think it's just a matter of understanding that they're really soldiers first, and, you know, their hearts are, they bury it quite a bit. So, I think so. I don't know, you know. She's playing hard to get now.
Well, nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that.
No. I think she's a good dumpy.
Yeah. And you and Coulson have a really interesting relationship, too. What's it been like developing that over the course of the season?
Well, I love it because it's so much fun working with Clark Gregg. And I mean, Coulson is sort of the father figure. And I feel like May is really more the mother figure in this whole group. So the dynamics between the two of us and how much we care about the team and how much we are dedicated to S.H.I.E.L.D. Those are all really great, and I just love having scenes with him. I think we have a really good chemistry.
No, you do. It definitely plays off. It plays on screen so that we get drawn more and more into the relationship there. And also who you can trust. You know, you're kind of cagey. You know, sometimes we think you like guys. Sometimes we think not so much.
Yes, yes. I'm always thrown like a curveball with the writers, and I think ultimately May is just a great soldier, and she really follows the orders that she's been given, and every so often she'll stray from it, but it's always with good intentions, I think.
What should people be more afraid of, touching Lola or calling you the cavalry in public?
Calling me the cavalry, I have to say. You know, Coulson, he's a softie. May not so much.
No, not so much. And what's it like doing all the stunts on the show? What kind of training do you do for that?
Well, we have a great stunt team that keeps me on my toes, you know. Whenever I don't feel like working out, they make sure that I get the workout that I'm supposed to. And I'm learning so much, you know, between the stunt fighting and actually learning how to do all the real martial arts stuff. Yeah. It's fun.
Well, then I think you'll definitely enjoy the movie tonight because there is a ton of kick-ass, great fight scenes in it.
So I can't wait. I'm really excited.
Well, thanks for talking to us and enjoy tonight.
Okay. Yes, thank you very much.
Take care. All right. Coming up next, we have Haley Atwell, Peggy Carter. Come on over.
Hi. How are you?
I'm great. You look beautiful. Who are you wearing?
I'm wearing Alice Templey, a British designer.
Fantastic, representing.
Yes, absolutely.
So what was it like for you to come back into this universe after the way things ended in The First Avenger?
Well, you never really expect that to happen. Mm-hmm. You don't sign up for a franchise with something like this that felt like it ended, you know, in the first one. So it was an unexpected, wonderful surprise to be back with the Marvel family, who take very good care of us and are lovely to work with, really genuine people.
And it really is a family, and something I love in this movie is friendship is really explored. So talk a little bit about, you know, how you think Captain America is adjusting to life in the modern age.
I think because of him being a superhero, it means that he adapts very quickly to his environment, and he's always on survival alert, you know, and the lookout for any kind of imminent danger. And because of that, it means that he just takes in his surroundings almost like a child would. So I think he's doing pretty well.
And how do you think Peggy would adapt if she suddenly woke up several decades later?
Oh, I just think she'd get on with it. She'd be a bit, I mean, she'd be relieved that, you know, the roles of women have been, you know, have moved forward. Not as much as she probably would have hoped. But I think she would have been like, well, it's about bloody time.
I totally agree. Well, thank you so much for talking with us. Have a fantastic time
at
the premiere tonight.
Good night.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, we are going to head back to Andrea to see what's going out in the arrivals area. Andrea, how is it going down there? Who are people excited to see, and how does everybody look?
Everybody looks amazing, as you would expect. The arrivals area is heating up with a lot of testosterone because a lot of the hunky males are here. Frank Grillo, who plays Brock Rumlow, he's arrived. He spent a lot of time with the fans. And actually, pretty much to the side of me, I don't know if you can pan over there, there is Chris Evans, Captain America. As you can see, he is signing shields. He is taking selfies. He's doing a lot. So that's going on right now with the red carpet. We want to say thank you so much for watching right now on Yahoo. And we'll keep it going with all the interviews with Tamara.
All right. I am so happy to be here with Samuel L. Jackson.
Yes.
All right, Nick Fury.
They actually had a board with my name on it so they wouldn't get it wrong.
Hey, I know your name. I could have done that without any kind of whiteboard.
You could have done that without a cue card?
I absolutely could have. Awesome. I have seen you at the Spirit Awards. I've seen you in movies. You are a fantastic independent film person. You've been on the jury at Sundance. I know my Samuel L. Jackson.
I get around.
Yeah, I know who you are. Don't worry.
Okay.
All right. So this movie, more than any other, really focuses on S.H.I.E.L.D. And you were talking to the Marvel fans. This is Marvel Live, streaming on Yahoo. So they know all about this. So what was your reaction when you first got the script and saw, you know, your involvement in it?
I was excited by it. I mean, to find out that we were doing something more than, you know, punching the bad guy in the face and, you know, doing a bunch of rocket and plane crashes and stuff like that, that we were actually going to deal with something that had substance was exciting. The intrigue aspect of the script, awesome. Yeah. The mystery, the doubt, the questions that, you know, arise, and the way everything kind of plays out is really exciting in terms of what an action film usually is, and this one has, you know, substance. So.
Yeah, I mean, it really does have substance. There are a lot of themes that are very relevant for today that, you know, it wouldn't matter if it were a superhero movie. It's just stuff that we can all relate to.
Yeah, well, the superhero stuff makes it even better.
Oh, yeah. We cannot forget the superhero stuff.
We like the super things.
Speaking of super things, you have a pretty super vehicle in this one. Tell me about that.
You know, it's a standard. I won't say it's a standard S.H.I.E.L.D. vehicle. It's probably Nick Fury's standard vehicle.
Yeah.
It's a high-tech, almost impenetrable machine that works on voice control. It works on manual. It does a lot of things, but, you know, it also takes a licking and keeps on ticking.
Absolutely. Something else, Anthony Mackie in here as the Falcon.
Who?
Oh, this guy named Anthony.
Him. Maybe. Oh, yeah, the new guy. Yeah. That vain guy, the new guy. The guy who thinks he's a bigger superhero than everybody in the movie.
Hey, what's that
with
all
no
about?
With no superpowers.
So what was it like for you guys to work together on this?
You know, it's awesome to be around Anthony. I've done several films with Anthony already. I think Chris has done a couple. Mm-hmm. So his energy coming into this was sort of perfect. Because he is the new kid on the block. Mm-hmm. He came in, he made friends really quickly. He learned how to play nicely with everybody. And he kept us laughing and singing and doing stuff. Nice. He's really, really a great addition.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for talking to the Marvel fans.
My pleasure.
Congrats on the movie.
Right.
Have a great time tonight.
Get out there and see us.
Can't wait. Listen to him. Thanks again.
All right.
Okay. You take care. All right, we are here with Luis D'Esposito, the executive producer. We are very excited to talk to him and to find out a little bit about the behind the scenes of the making of this movie. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Nice
to see you again.
Great to see you too. So we were last here, Thor, The Dark World.
Yes.
Fast forward a couple months, this movie is tracking so well.
Yes.
What are you excited about?
Well, I'm excited. It's different than the original Cap. Obviously, that was set in the 1940s during the Greatest Generation. Mm-hmm. This is modern day, and this is we liken it to a political thriller. So you put Cap, he's a soldier working for a spy organization, and that makes for a lot of conflict and a lot of turmoil.
Yeah.
Yes. And Cap comes out on top, as you know, as you would suspect.
Really? Are you sure? Did you just give away the end?
I have to see the film again, but I'm quite sure.
Yeah, I think Cap does pretty all right.
Yes.
What was it that made this movie the right movie to explore the Winter Soldier storyline?
Well, it's been one of the most popular books in the Cap canon. Mm-hmm. And it was great because we had a great actor playing Bucky in the Winter Soldier. So the combination of the two, we thought it was great to explore. And people are going to come away loving Sebastian Stan.
Oh, my God. We were talking about that before, how he telegraphs so much just with his eyes.
He's so handsome. Don't we have such a beautiful-looking cast?
We do.
Right. That's why you'd rather be speaking to them than me right now.
Hey, I like finding out about what goes on behind the scenes and in front of the screen. So.
Yes. Anyway, thank you. It was great seeing you again.
And it was great to see you, too.
All righty.
Congrats. Right. Enjoy tonight.
And everyone, come see the film.
Everyone, come see the film. Just a reminder, it opens in the United States on April 4th. It opens internationally on a different date, so check your rollout. Hello, we are here with Max Hernandez.
Hello.
Known as Jasper Sitwell.
Yes, Agent Jasper Sitwell, for those who don't know.
Being sneaky as usual.
Oh, yes, there's a lot of sneaking around. I some people kick butt and take names. I just take the names. That's my job. That's what I do.
He says that very innocently. I'm not so sure I believe him.
You shouldn't believe it. You shouldn't believe a word I say.
So you are actually one of the people who crosses over between Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and the Marvel movies. Tell me what that's been like to play in both playgrounds.
You know, it's really great because they have amazing coordination where literally scenes kind of pick up and start off in the movie. Like I have a scene with Clark in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and like the next thing is I have to be somewhere else, and then you find out that somewhere else is this movie. So
not a bad place to be.
No, not a bad place to be. Like, oh, you've got to go and do this thing over by that place, and then you find out where I am, and so I think people will be very surprised.
Yeah.
A lot of surprises in this movie. It definitely is going to be the twistiest and turniest of all the Marvel films, I think.
But that's one of the cool things, is that we do get this genre action conspiracy thriller this time around.
You know what? I love it. And I think with the addition of Robert Redford as Alexander Pierce, it gives you that real, you know, 3 Days of the Condor kind of feeling in every way. And when people see it, they're going to be like, oh, okay, this is a different type of political thriller, because that's basically what it is. You know, it's the least superhero-y of the superhero movies. It really is more like a detective novel. A lot of layers, a lot of peeling things back, and a lot of reveal happens in this movie.
That's true. Now, question for you, because it is indeed a superhero movie, for sure. We have not left any of that out. If you could have Falcon's wings or jetpack, or if you could have Cap's shield, which one would you go for?
Ooh. Wings or shield? Oh. I take the wings, because I don't have Cap's power. I don't have his strength, so I would have to take to be able to fly away, because I'll punk out, and I'll just... I will not. I won't fight. I'll just fly away, and so I think I'll take. I think I take Falcon's wings.
You take Falcon's wings. Yep. All right. Good to know.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much, and you guys have fun and go check out the movie. It's going to be amazing. Trust me.
Excellent.
Trust Jasper.
I don't know if you should trust Jasper. I'm not so sure about that. Next up, we have Joe and Anthony Russo, the directors of Captain America, The Winter Soldier. They are known for Community, for Arrested Development, and we are very excited to talk with them and see what it was like bringing this film to the big screen.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Anthony.
How are you?
Hi. So we are talking directly to the Marvel fans. This is streaming live on Yahoo. Introduce yourselves, please.
Anthony Russo.
And hi, this is Joe Russo.
They directed this little movie called Captain America, The Winter Soldier. So, for you guys, comics fans growing up, what was it like when you got the call to do this? What went through your minds?
I don't know. I think I fainted. I don't remember. Do you remember?
Pretty much. Something like that, yeah.
Honestly, I started collecting comics when I was 10. One of the first books I ever got my hands on was a Captain America Falcon team up. So this really is a 30-year dream come true for us.
Yeah.
And speaking of Falcon, what was it about Anthony Mackie that made you guys know he is our Falcon?
There's a lot of pressure when you are going to introduce a new character into the into the Marvel Cinematic Universe. So, look, we knew we needed somebody who delivered everything. You believed as a superhero who had that kind of strength, who had that kind of charisma, who could hold his own with actors like Chris Evans and Scarlett Johansson and Sam Jackson. And Anthony Mackie is just a wonderful addition to the family.
Another question I'm dying to ask you guys. So let's talk Cleveland for a minute.
Yeah.
You were shooting this massive movie in your hometown. I know you did a smaller film there with George Clooney and Steven Soderbergh involved.
Right.
What was it like to go back with a film of this size and scale?
It was fantastic to have that support system there, to have family and friends so close to you. Plus, it's our hometown. It's a town that we love. We grew up there. We know it so well. So visually, we knew where to look for the best locations for the movie. We couldn't have asked for better to be working on a Captain America film and to be shooting it in Cleveland. It's a double whammy for us.
You guys also got to shoot in D.C. What was it like shooting in and around the monument? It looks gorgeous. Yeah. It looks absolutely gorgeous.
Look, it's thrilling to be in Washington, D.C., and as you can imagine, it's a very complicated place to shoot because security is so high, etc. But we had a few days there, and we got some wonderful footage with the actors there. It was really fantastic, yeah.
And also,
I should just say, seeing Captain America in the nation's capital, it carries a lot of emotional weight with it, yeah.
Yeah, the way the film opens is absolutely beautiful. I'm a runner, and it just made me want to jump into the screen.
That's cool.
Yeah. Something a lot of people have been talking about, too, are the themes of this movie and how it really is a very relevant story to kind of what we're all going through right now. Can you talk a little bit about the development of that?
Sure. We're making a political thriller, and our favorite political thrillers when we were growing up were very relevant to the times in which the film was made. They're culturally relevant, they're topically relevant, and it creates an immediacy for the audience. You know, they sense the paranoia of the lead character because they have the same anxieties about the world around them. So it's very important for us to have topical themes in the film, especially topical political themes. We read a lot. I'm on Dig every day in BuzzFeed and, CNN and Huffington Post. And, we're getting our news, and I have all the same anxieties that Cap has in the movie about drone technology and preemptive strikes and civil liberty issues, and so we wanted to put all that in the film to just add another layer of texture to the movie.
Well, it definitely shows. I want to congratulate you guys. I saw the movie the other night. It's fantastic.
Hopefully,
no anxiety tonight. Just have a great time.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it. And thanks to all the fans out there.
We
made this for them.
Excellent. All right. Thank you guys so much. All right, next up we have Titus Welliver, who plays Agent Blake on Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. We are so excited, Titus Welliver, to have you here.
Thank you. It's great to be here. Very excited.
We are streaming live, talking directly to the Marvel fans. What's it been like to be a part of the Marvel Universe?
Fantastic. It's a dream come true. I mean, I've been a Marvel fan since I was a little boy, and now that I'm an old man, I can still enjoy it. So it's fantastic.
And this is a huge red carpet. What's it like to come and see how incredibly excited the fans are here to support this whole universe?
I completely get it. If I wasn't in it, I'd probably be here too, screaming from the sidelines, Clark Gregg!
All right, now the question is, would you have Cap Shield or would you want the wings?
Cap Shield.
Yeah, how come?
It goes farther and it comes back.
All right, well, thank you for coming back to talk to us. Have a fantastic time tonight. Enjoy the premiere.
Thanks very much. Nice to see you.
Me too.
Nice to see you. It's really cool to see so many of the cast members of Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. coming out to support this movie. Next up, we have Emily Van Camp, who plays Agent 13. She is a new face here in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, known to many fans for Revenge and started out on Everword. And here she is, gorgeous in this beautiful dress.
Thank you. How are you?
I'm great. I'm great. So how does it feel to be part of this huge premiere?
It's intense. It's kind of amazing. You know, so many fans are out here to support, and you just kind of feel the love. It's really wonderful. Yeah. It's really exciting to be a part of this.
And for you, you know, one of the things Marvel is so fantastic about is creating strong female characters. So when you first read the script, what was your reaction?
I mean, I've sort of gravitated toward characters like that my whole career. As you can see on Revenge as well, it's like another level of that. But, you know, who doesn't dream, you know, as a kid to be in a movie like this, playing the kind of character that I get to play? It was amazing. And, you know, I love these films even before I was a part of them. So it was very exciting.
And, you know, you said that you weren't a comic book fan growing up. Uh-huh. You've since become one. But yet there's going to be a graphic novel from Revenge.
Yes.
Can you talk a little bit about that?
I'm so excited about it. Well, I mean, our storyline really lends itself well for a graphic novel. I'm surprised it didn't happen sooner, to be honest. You know, she's a vigilante of sorts. We have all of these already, like, ingrained characters that everyone sort of connects with and understands and knows. So it's very exciting for us. And I've always looked at Revenge as, you know, having that comic book quality to it. And I've always sort of played that heightened reality. We all sort of do. And visually, we try to make it like that. So it's very exciting that this is actually happening, because it makes sense to me.
Very, very cool. And last question, of course, working with Chris Evans, Captain America. Tell me a little bit about what that was like.
It was awesome. I have a couple really good friends from Boston, and I remember thinking, oh, he's from Boston, he's going to be cool, and he was exactly like my buddies from Boston, just like really lovely, polite, funny, and cool. And I mean, that to me was like, okay, because it's intimidating walking onto a set like this. I don't care who you are, it's like, wow, there's a lot going on. A lot of people that have really inspired you over the years. You know, my first day, I think, was with Robert Redford. And
I was going to say, you have a scene with Robert Redford.
I thought to myself, like, how is this going to go down? Like, he was the sweetest, loveliest man, too, but just so iconic. So it was very nerve-wracking. And honestly, everyone was so kind to me and just very welcoming. And it made it that much easier. And Chris is just lovely. I mean, he's the perfect Captain America, let's be honest.
I know, you can hear all the fans screaming for him right now.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
As they should be.
Well, you have a fantastic time tonight. You have earned it. The film is wonderful, and you're wonderful in it.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Have a good night.
All right, bye. I don't know why I was waving goodbye. I'm here, but I am staying here with all of you who are watching this streaming live on Yahoo. Of course, this is brought to you by Zing Revolution. Coming up next, we have Sebastian Stan, the Winter Soldier. Hello, sir.
Hi, how are you?
I'm great. How are you doing tonight?
I'm good, thanks.
You're welcome. So I'm not going to embarrass you now. We were talking before about how expressive your eyes are in this role. You know, you're playing someone who we don't see your face for a lot of the movie. Talk about that experience as an actor. What was that like for you?
It was a little bit weird. The mask was definitely very strange, but there's definitely something to be said about not recognizing yourself in the mirror, you know. Sometimes you kind of get used to doing certain things as an actor, relying on certain looks, I suppose, or certain gimmicks, and frankly, when I looked at myself in the mirror, I was stripped away of everything. I was sort of kind of like a new person, so that really helped me a lot in the long run.
And speaking of, you know, being stripped away and new things added, my jewelry was inspired by your arm tonight.
Wow.
So talk about working with the arm. What was that like, stunt-wise, makeup-wise, and all of that?
The arm was a little bit difficult. I mean, we had a couple of them. There was a sort of a hero arm, which was how we refer to the one that looked the most, the shiniest, and that was also the least flexible one. Yeah. But I kind of was like, we got to use that one. It just looks the best. I feel the best wearing it. So it was a little tough because we had to be flexible and the costume was a little constricting. But, you know, pants fell down a couple times.
That didn't make it in the movie.
Yeah. I slipped off of a car. I mean, you know, funny things happen, but in the end it went well.
And you also, I heard that you did a lot of practicing on set with a knife, kind of your fight choreography. Can you give us a little demo of that? You know, if I'm, is there anything I should know about?
Well, I don't have a knife right now, but...
Okay, so you're done practicing for now.
I am, I guess. I don't know. Maybe I should start again.
I don't think there's any danger here tonight. You don't need to worry about that.
Well, not necessarily about the danger tonight, about what's looming ahead.
Who knows? And as far as, you know, your relationship with Chris Evans, with Steve Rogers, is obviously so different in this film. What was it like working with Chris, you know?
I mean, I got along with Chris so well in the first movie. It was one of the perks of sort of coming back to do another one and knowing that, you know, you're working with somebody you can trust and someone who has a sense of humor. And, you're on a set for 12, 13 hours. And, I mean, you want to get along with the people you work with. And Chris is, he's a great chameleon. I mean, he's just the right balance of having a good time and at the same time being serious and dedicated.
And when you were originally cast as Bucky, you knew the Winter Soldier storyline was out there?
I did, because I read the comic books, yeah.
Okay. So when they called you and said, hey man, we're doing it, what was your reaction?
It was, I pictured myself getting that phone call for a while and sort of screaming and kind of, but when it finally happened, it was actually just complete silence. I was like, just overwhelmed for a second, but just really thrilled.
Yeah, and which was your favorite scene to shoot?
All the fight sequences,
yeah.
Because we worked really hard and we did it. It's a lot of us in there, so
yeah.
I'm really proud of it.
Can you actually, you know, something that I think the fans might really be interested in knowing about is what is that process like of you learn the choreography and then you have to show up and you actually have to act? How do you get from one to the other so you're not telegraphing everything?
Well, it's just repetition. I mean, there's really, it's kind of like learning piano, basically. I mean, it's just so specific and meticulous, and you just have to do it over and over again, and it's just a process of repetition, and you have to be patient, because you see the stunt guys are you know, doing it so well, and you really want to get it, but you have to just kind of take it one beat at a time.
Well, thank you for taking it one beat at a time. We saw the movie the other night. It's wonderful. Have a great time tonight.
Thank you. It's a pleasure. Thanks.
All right, guys, that was Sebastian Stan, the Winter Soldier. He is very charming in person. He is very, very menacing and scary on screen. He has really put in a wonderful performance as an incredible, incredible Marvel villain. So we have more stars making their way, including Chris Evans, Captain America. He is coming down the carpet, and we are very, very excited to talk to him, of course, as he anchors this whole movie. Come on over. Hey. Hello, sir.
How are you?
I am great. How are you doing tonight?
Very well.
Excellent.
Is it weird seeing yourself right here on the camera? Because you don't know this, but there's like a camera right here that you see yourself.
Yeah. It is, honestly, it is very strange.
Watch, I'm going to keep looking. I won't.
Eyes here.
Eyes there. Keep them up.
All right. So look, I know you're a Boston boy.
That's right.
But the film opens with this incredible footage of you running through DC. So what was that like? I'm a runner. It looks amazing.
It was great. That's the best thing about Marvel. They really know how to incorporate different environments to give texture to the story. And DC is such a backbone to the story. To open with those iconic shots mm-hmm. of our nation's capital, it was really beautiful.
Yeah. And did you shoot those early in the morning, late at night?
Oh, very early in the morning. The sun hadn't even risen. It was a slow process. Everyone was waking up.
You and the Falcon have an incredible relationship in this movie. So much of this movie is about friendship. Talk about the evolution of that relationship in the film.
Sure. Well, Cap doesn't have a secret identity. He's one of those superheroes that everyone knows. And as a result, I think he is a little wary of people who are only interested in knowing him for his celebrity status. When he first meets Sam Wilson, Mackie's character, he treats him like a man. He treats him like a soldier.
Yeah.
And as a result, I think Cap finds an immediate comfort, and that friendship is not only necessary to Cap's personal life, but it ends up being pretty necessary to the script.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's a lot of shades of gray in this movie. You know, Cap kind of wandering between figuring out, I want to do right, but what is right? What excited you most about that element of the script when you read it?
What's that?
The whole idea that Cap is really trafficking in a very gray world here. What excited you about the way you were going to see Cap develop this time around?
Sure. Well, they gave Cap some conflict. You know, he's such a good man. His MO is to not bleed on people. So if you have a guy who refuses to show his weakness, it can be challenging to find a dynamic arc.
Yeah.
And in this film, they make it difficult for him to understand who he's working for. Mm-hmm. It's not necessarily about adjusting to modern technology. It's about adjusting to modern society. And it's a gray area for Cap.
Well, there's no gray area about this film. It's fantastic. Thank you so much for talking to the Marvel fans.
Thank you. Thank you.
Have a great night tonight. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay. That was Captain America himself, Chris Evans. We are now going to head down to Andrea in the arrivals area to see who is showing up. Andrea, how's it going down there?
It's going great down here. Tamara, it sounds amazing. You have a very, I'm very jealous of your job that you just got to talk to Chris Evans. Amazing. So the arrivals area has been absolutely insane because Scarlett Johansson has shown up, the Black Widow, and she looked incredible. Friends of the fans of the Black Widow will definitely not be disappointed. She looks very va-va-voom, absolutely amazing. Everyone's been spending a lot of time with the fans, and the people have just been eating it up. This has been an incredible arrivals area. The energy is absolutely insane, and I can tell that the fans will not be disappointed when they actually get to the theater when it comes out April 4th, because this film is epic. Everyone is incredible in it, all the actors, and this is now their time to shine. All right, but here we have more stars with you tomorrow, so let's get back to the red carpet.
All right, we are waiting for the next arrival here with us. We have Frank Grillo. Brock Rumlow, come on over.
Hello, how are you?
I'm fantastic. How are you?
I'm great. I'm very excited to be here.
I'm a little scared of you after seeing this movie.
You are? You should be.
I know,
no,
right?
No, I'm very misunderstood.
Is that what it is?
That's what it is. Yeah, there's no good and bad.
No, well, this movie really is all shades of gray. You don't know who to trust.
Yeah, really, you know, when I read the script, I was like, wow, this is really very different than all of these other Marvel movies. So, and that's what I you know, from what I've read, people have responded to that.
I definitely responded to it. Did you go back and read some of the comics that featured Brock?
Yeah, I did. Because this is an origin film for this character. And so I did go back. And I have a 17-year-old son, fortunately, who knows all about these characters, so he gave me the cheat sheets.
Nice. So what was his reaction when he heard that you actually got cast in this part?
Oh, I have three sons, and I have to tell you, I'm the hero in the house. Yeah, I don't care, bad guy, good guy, they don't care.
I do have a 3.5-year-old daughter, and she was very excited when she heard I was meeting Captain America.
Yeah, I mean, I have to deal with that, like I'm not Captain America, but I think they're starting to understand it's okay.
Yeah. It's okay. So you have some incredible action scenes in this movie. Talk to me a little bit about what it was like shooting on the ship and what your favorite sequence was.
Yeah, I think my favorite sequence was the elevator sequence.
Yeah.
Because it was so physical. It took us 6 or 7 days to actually shoot that.
Really?
Yeah, and the fight choreography was very specific, and I kind of dig that stuff, and Chris's game, so it was a lot of fun.
Yeah. Well, this isn't your first rodeo with action stuff, so.
No, and it won't be my last.
I hope not. I hope not. And, you know, this film is really relevant in so many ways. You know, what was it like sort of operating in this shadowy world of not knowing who to trust?
I like that. I kind of dug it, and it was very ambiguous about the moral aspect of the film. It's still, there's an ambiguity about who's right and who's wrong and who's good, so I dug it. You know, it really was, from an acting standpoint, it was neat.
And if you were to perhaps get a superhuman accoutrement, would you want a Cap shield? Would you want the wings? What would you want?
I'd want his handsome face and his physique, I think.
You've got your own handsome face and physique.
I can't stand him. No, thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks so much for joining us here tonight. We are very excited for you. Enjoy the night.
Thanks so much.
You're welcome.
Bye.
All right, Andrea, back to you. What is happening down there? We can hear a lot of screams. I'm excited to see who keeps showing up. How are things happening down in your side of the carpet?
Hey, Tamara. Well, the screams were for Aaron Taylor Johnson, who will be playing Quicksilver in Avengers Age of Ultron, and then also Adewale Akinoye Akbaje. You will remember him from Thor the Dark World. He also arrived here. But the sun is setting here in Hollywood. Pretty much everyone has arrived, so now it's just a countdown to when all of the actors assemble at the end of the carpet, and then we get to see the premiere of this amazing film. All right, Tamara, let's go back to you and talk to the stars.
Okay, I am very happy to be here with Clark Gregg. Phil Coulson, I have something for you.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
You might want to be careful with that. It allowed me to get into a few very exciting places earlier today.
That is my badge that you happen to have here.
We're sneaky that way. I just look like a TV host, but, you know, there's a lot going on here.
It's amazing that you had this and you didn't abuse it, because this can get you into some very tricky places and a lot of trouble, and sometimes it can get an Asgardian war scepter right through the middle of you.
I didn't say I didn't abuse it.
Oh, really? I'm going to get it, because it does have a charge facility. I'm sure that I'm going to get a hell of a bill. This is a big deal. This is not something that's easily come by. This is for an agent of S.H.I.E.L.D. And if you lose this...
So you should be a little more careful with that, maybe.
I will be a lot more careful with it. Director Fury does not like people being reckless with their badges, and I thank you for returning it to me. I feel like I owe you a giant debt of gratitude.
Well, you owe me something. We'll talk about that later.
Okay,
but right now what I want to talk about is the fact that, you know, Coulson has kind of grown a pair this time around. You know, you definitely take chances. You are not afraid to push authority a little bit. We've really seen your character develop throughout the series.
This is true. I mean, you know, I would argue in the Avengers, he demonstrated some moxie, yeah, fronting off with that bastard Loki. But certainly, he was a company man in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Enough is going on. There's enough chaos afoot. Chaos that I have a feeling might get explored a little bit in this film tonight, that he's a little bit less of a company man and starting to push back to the powers that be.
Absolutely. Well, enjoy the film tonight. We can't wait to see what continues in the rest of the season.
Thank you. I can't wait.
You're welcome. All right. We're going to head back down to Andrea to see what's happening in the Arrivals area. The stars just keep on coming because this Marvel Universe, they support one another. They show up for all of each other's films. When they say it's a family, it really is. I really wish I could get that badge back, though. I could do a lot of damage with that. Andrea, how is it going down there?
It's going great. You're right. It is a family, and there's a lot of support. And we actually really appreciate the support of Zing Revolution, who has sponsored this live stream and been able to bring it to you guys all over the world. And we actually had Zing Revolution's Cameron talk to all of the fans here. So let's take a look at what craziness happened earlier today.
How y'all doing? You guys must be so excited to be a Captain America. Now when I say Zing, you shout revolution! Zing!
Revolution!
Zing!
Revolution!
Zing!
Revolution!
Zing!
Revolution!
Yeah! Hi everybody, I'm Cameron Maslavi Jones, the official teen spokesperson for Zing Revolution. I'm here with...
Sean.
Teresa.
Katie.
And how are you guys? You must be so excited to be at the Captain America premiere.
Excited and exhausted.
Oh man, speechless.
It's amazing.
Obviously very, very committed fan, so I'm assuming Captain America is your favorite from the Marvel Universe.
Of course, and Bucky.
Oh, yeah, no question there.
He's always been my favorite.
Always been your favorite, a true American sweetheart. So, if you were to make me, including my hair and all, you know, this luscious mane, what would you make my powers? What would be my name as a superhero?
Cam the Magnificent, Master of Teleportation.
Call you Samson, all your powers in your hair.
The great unknown, and you would have unlimited power.
Very, very much mysteriousness. I enjoy that. Well, basically, you guys must be so enthralled to be here at this premiere. And I just want to know, how long were you here waiting to see this and all these stars on the red carpet?
We got here at 6 in the morning.
6 in the morning? Are you guys all here together?
Yeah, we're all here.
Definitely here together.
Well, it's great to see that Marvel Comics can bring together such great fans, all based around the Marvel Universe. Guys, I want to thank you so much for coming out here and totally enjoy the premiere. Let me hear you one more time. Sing! You heard it from us, guys. Cameron Maslavi Jones, the official teen spokesperson for Zing Revolution. See you around.
How did it go?
Hey everyone, we are streaming live on Yahoo, and we are here with Kobe Smulders.
Oh shoot, I'm live. I mean.
Hi, we'll talk to you guys later.
Yes.
Okay.
You're just making friends everywhere, aren't
you? We're just hanging out. It's very distracting to see yourself on like a little screen down here. I don't know where to look. I'll look at you and your beautiful bluey green eyes.
Oh, thank you.
How beautiful is this woman?
Oh my God, you can stay here all day. I could say the same thing about you.
Stop it.
No, really, I can. We're having a moment. Sorry, guys. Her skin is really soft, too.
Ooh,
really, really
soft.
I'll
take it all the way to the bank.
All right. Well, you take this movie to the bank. You're pretty kick-ass in it.
I haven't seen this yet.
Really?
No, I haven't. I mean, obviously, I read it, and I...
That's good. That's good.
I read my parts. I mean, no, I...
My line.
Yeah, my line. They speak. My line. Yeah. But I don't know how it turned out. I hear amazing things about it. It was an awesome script, and we had two of the greatest directors.
Yeah. I have a question about that. So yeah? Two directors. What is it like working with two directors? Is it like mom and dad? You don't get what you want from one, you go to the other. How's that work?
You know, they've worked together so much that I think that they have it down pat where you don't really, you kind of just go like, Russo's. And whoever you get, that's fine. And it's like, because they both kind of, they work really well together, and they work with, like, I want to say, like, one would, like, work with actors, and the other one would be, like, working with the camera, but they do both. So they're kind of interchangeable. But they were excellent.
If you have double excellence, I think that's a good way to go.
Yeah.
Well, you are triply excellent in this movie. You're very stealthy, and we love the action.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I like fake hitting people a lot. It's fun.
Be careful. She's dangerous. Unfortunately, there are a lot of people here who want to talk to her, so we have to let her go.
Oh, well, very nice to talk to you, and you, the live web. Is this on the live web?
This is actually streaming live on Yahoo.
The internet. I've heard of this thing.
Yes.
Called the interweb.
Exactly.
Well, very nice to meet you.
You too. Thanks so much.
We'll see you later.
Definitely.
See you at the after party?
I hope so.
All right. Good drink.
All right. Today.
All right.
Bye,
okay.
Everyone.
That was Kobe Smulders,
thank
Maria
you
Hill. She is lovely. I think I have my next girl crush on Kobe Smulders now. Yeah. Okay.
Hello,
sir. How are you?
I'm excellent. How are you?
I'm good. So how are you feeling tonight?
This is pretty exciting. Not just for Marvel, but just S.H.I.E.L.D. in general. It's it's an awesome night for everybody.
Absolutely. Standing right.
Oh, my gosh. Look at this.
Come here.
Now Handsome comes in.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So so you guys know, we are streaming live to the Marvel audience on Yahoo.
Audience.
This whole thing is brought to us by Zing Revolution. So tell us a little bit more about what it's been like now that you're almost through a whole season of Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
It's fantastic.
That much fun, huh?
It's been amazing. It's our first television production out of Marvel. Being able to have, Brad on the show has been awesome. Clark Gray. We just have an amazing cast and great directors and amazing writers, and we incredibly thankful to our fans, and it's just been fun. So I think that's the best thing. And we're barreling towards our season finale, and starting on February 1st. We're going to do... Are we allowed to talk about that? I can't remember.
February 1st?
February 1st,
I'm sorry.
Wait.
No, not April 1st. April 1st. That was an April 1st joke. We're doing 7 in a row.
Yes.
So for those of you out there that have been wanting your S.H.I.E.L.D. every week, starting April 1st, 7 in a row all the way out there to the season finale.
All right, now I think fans of the show would be very upset with me if I did not ask about what's going on with you and May these days.
Oh.
Had a bit of an upset this week, didn't you?
We did. We might have had a little bit of a talk in the cockpit. And,
cheater! Dirty cheater, you!
I was under the influence. I was a victim in that whole thing.
Yeah.
Really?
Oh, now it's a party!
Oh,
dear.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
All right, well, Jeff.
Our very own Chloe Bennett. Handsome
Jeff, thank you so much for talking
with
us.
I'm going to let you go in.
All right.
Jack.
Tag in, tag out.
Okay, tag out.
Thank you so much, Jeff.
Tag in, tag out. Look at us. We're on the big screen.
Yeah, there is a very big screen here as we are here live on Hollywood Boulevard.
Left. They just left me to myself. Hi, guys. How are you?
Good. We are talking live to the Marvel fans.
Brett's back. Everybody, take note.
How does it feel to be here in this huge... How does it feel to be here?
It's pretty awesome. My dad keeps trying to FaceTime me, and I just did, but he's like, I want to be there. So I feel bad, but he says hi to everyone here. He says hi to you, actually. I showed him you from afar. He says you look great in maroon or burgundy.
Thank you. Wow.
What is this, maroon or burgundy?
I don't know.
You don't know. You just look handsome.
All right. You guys, I'm going to let you continue your conversation.
She's
thank you guys so much for joining us.
Thank you.
And we look forward to the rest of the series.
Bye. Okay.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you. All right, guys, we have next Adewale Akinnoye Agbaji.
Wow, that was fantastic.
Did I
get it? You got it.
Yes!
You smashed it. How you doing?
Smashed. Well, we like to smash things here in the Marvel Universe.
Yeah, this is the place to smash things, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Now, in case you don't recognize this beautiful face without the makeup, we're talking to Algrim and Curse from Thor the Dark World.
Great to be here, man. Another big Marvel event, and excited to see this. I love the first one.
Yeah.
And really excited to see this new character as well, a Falcon, you know what I mean, and support that, and just really happy to be part of this little Marvel family. It's always a party.
Well, you know, when you were here when we talked in November, it was your movie we were going to see. What's it like being here to support somebody else's movie, a little more relaxed?
It is. You see, there's no tie. I just relax, yeah. You know. I mean, it's great because I'm a fan, first of all. Yeah. So just to be able to come and watch a movie without the pressure of you being in it and all of that stuff is great. And also support some of your other actors, because it's not always that we're around at the same time. Myself and Anthony Mackie, we did a small film, The Inevitable Defeat of Mr. and Pete, and that was a few years ago since we've seen it. So, you know, just to support, you know, the guys that you know, and Sam and you know, all the other actors.
I'm about to talk to Anthony Mackie. Is there any message you want to pass along or any tidbit I should talk to him about?
Just congratulations, man, and enjoy, I should say, the flight, you know what I mean? Not even the ride, yeah. I mean, just congratulations. It's just, you know, it's an iconic character that we all grew up playing, so I'm just glad it came to fruition, and he's an amazing actor. It's great for him.
Well, I think you're going to love him in this film. I saw it the other night.
Seen it,
he's, yeah it's amazing.
It.
I did.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah. Well, have a fantastic time tonight. Enjoy the party.
All right. Thank you.
Right. Take care. Bye. All right. We do have Anthony Mackie making his way down the carpet. We are so excited to talk to him. The Falcon is incredible in this film. You know, they've updated his costume a little bit. When the Russo brothers were trying to decide what they wanted to do, they decided to get rid of some of the more comic booky elements of the costume that they didn't feel would translate very well into a realistic, gritty thriller. And he has this incredible, incredible wing pack that he gets to use. And when he was talking at Comic-Con last summer, he talked about the fact that, you know, Falcon, he's a character that has wings and guns. What could be cooler? And it definitely translates. So we're going to talk to him about what it was like working with the jetpack, and hopefully a little bit about what it was like doing some of the wire work on the film, because they were able to send him 70 feet high in the air, land him on a little piece of tape, and just have him walk into a scene. So that's pretty magical. It looks pretty magical on screen. You know, it's been a great night here so far. We've gotten to see most of the major stars of the movie. Chris Evans, Scarlett Johansson still making her way down the carpet. So, you come back here.
Oh, I didn't even see you here. Hey.
Hey, look who I'm with.
How's it going? That is deviously beautiful. Blue is your color. I like it.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Well, I look much better now that you're standing next to me.
Oh, stop it. Stop it.
You are so good in this movie. So
much
fun to
watch. Thank you. I appreciate it. It was fun making. I mean, it's not often as an actor you go into a movie knowing it's going to be a great final product. Mm-hmm. And it kind of takes all the pressure off you. So we just had a good time and went to work and made a good movie.
Well, you also got to work with some people who you have worked with in the past and love working with, like you and Chris Evans
like
have worked
Chris
together.
Like Chris Evans, like Sam Jackson, Sebastian and I are good friends. Actually, the only person in this movie that this was my first time meeting them was Scarlett.
Ah, and so what was your first time with Scarlett like?
She was very normal. Like, you would expect someone who looks like her and have her status and everything to be a raving lunatic.
Right.
And she couldn't be further from that. Like, she's the sweetest, coolest chick you've ever met.
Awesome. Let's talk about working with the Wing Pack. Let's talk about working with the Wires.
Yes.
How was that?
It was great. It was the Wires were possibly the most painful experience of my life. I don't care what anyone says, hand down, I'm stopping the conversation now. The hardest working actors in Hollywood are flying superheroes, hands down. Nobody else experiences harnesses and wires and running in the vans face first at 15 miles an hour. No one else experiences that.
Well, that is kind of crazy. You clearly have earned this party here tonight, because you do all of that in this movie.
I did all of it. I have a great stuntman, and he just got beat up every day, and I applauded him from afar.
Well, thank you so much for stopping to talk to us, talking to the Marvel fans. You have a great
time
tonight.
Thank you, Marvel fans. Enjoy the movie, Captain America 2, The Winter Soldier.
Woohoo!
Ha-ha, a crazy accent, yeah.
I like it. Save it for the next one. All right, that was Anthony Mackie, the Falcon. Scarlett is now making her way down the carpet. We are very excited to talk to her, to talk about what she wanted to do with Natasha in this film, or Nat, as Captain America calls her, although he may be the only one who gets away with calling her Nat. I don't think I want to try that. She's a little intimidating. Not Scarlett, Natasha Romanoff. And she is right behind me. She is talking to some of her co-stars in the film, and we're going to get to her in just a moment. Here she comes. Here she is. Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. I suddenly feel very tall. They have me on a box. I'm not usually like this.
You should be on a box or a pedestal. Well. Let's be honest.
So you are so fantastic in this film. I never know when to trust you or not.
Good. I like to keep you on your feet. You know, never. The widow is sort of. She doesn't have a sort of. Her moral compass is not like maybe yours or mine. She's kind of a gray character. She's a mercenary to begin with, so I think she's got a bit of a sordid past.
Well, this film may have Captain America's name in the title, but it is so much about you and how she evolves. What were you most excited about when you saw where they went with her in the script?
I was trying to get them to switch the name of this film for so long.
What is up with that?
What is up with that? Come on, I wanted it to be like Captain America, but it's really a Widow movie. You know what I mean? Like, just in parentheses. I think the most exciting thing about this, reading this script and developing this script from kind of early on was really that I felt like I got to have a lot of input this time around. It's kind of, I think the Avengers is such a huge kind of larger than life production, and so many character stories enmeshed and intertwined. And in this film, you know, we really get to focus on the relationship between Cap and Widow, and also learn a little bit more about kind of who she is outside of the job. So it was fun for me to be able to incorporate my backstory that I'd been developing and finally get a chance to play that here.
Those are the scenes between you and Cap are some of my favorite scenes in this entire movie. I think that the fans are really, really going to enjoy that.
Thank you. Thank you. It's, you know, Chris and I have known each other for 10 years. This is our fourth movie together. And, you know, we really finally got an opportunity to do some kind of dramatic work. Who would have thought it would be in this film? But we really did. And I think those 10 years that we've known each other, really benefited us in this production.
Yes, they absolutely did. I sadly have to send you on your way because there are so many people here who want to talk to you. But thank you for talking to us, to the Marvel fans.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Have a great time tonight.
Thank you. And you stay up there. You look good up there.
Be tall. Thank you so much. All right, that was Scarlett Johansson. And as she said, she and Chris have known each other for over 10 years. And they really have this incredible rapport in this movie. And it's so interesting because it's not a romantic relationship. It is two friends. And she, she's not afraid to give him a little bit. And it's nice to see Cap get pushed around a little bit. And to see him have some friends. So much of this movie is indeed about friendship. Cap has lost everybody who he was close to. He left them all behind many, many decades ago. And so it's so interesting to see, you know, how he and Natasha's relationship has developed, the new friendship with the Falcon. Of course, you know, there's tons and tons of source material to mine for that because Cap and the Falcon in the comics have such a long history. And, there's other friendships. There's a lot also about his friendship with Nick Fury. Or is it a friendship? That's one of the big questions of the movie, what exactly their relationship is. I don't know if you can hear right now, there's a helicopter going around. There is a lot still going on at this premiere. Slowly, all of the stars are making their way down to the other end of the carpet where they are all going to be gathering on stage for the first time because this is indeed the world premiere of Marvel's Captain America, The Winter Soldier, opening in theaters in the U.S. on April 4th. Thank you so much for watching this, streaming live on Yahoo. We want to thank our friends at Zing Revolution for sponsoring this broadcast. You can probably hear the fans screaming. That is because the stars are starting to gather. They're so excited to see everybody together. And as you can hear, this sounded like a really congenial set where everybody had such a good time working together. You know, it's tough when you're doing these stunt scenes. It takes, when you're doing these big action scenes, it takes a lot of time to film them. Everything has to be very, very precise. So when you're actually able to work with friends and have that downtime between, relax a little bit, then it definitely makes the movie making experience a little bit easier. So we are hoping to show you soon the cast all together. And I want to remind everybody, please do stick around, because at the end of this show, at the end of this Marvel Live show, we are going to show you an exclusive clip from the film. Still a couple of weeks until we open, so I know that you're not going to want to miss that. If you want to join in on the conversation, I want to remind you to use the hashtag CapWorldPremiere. And, of course, you can always follow all things Captain America at the official Captain America Twitter handle, at Captain America, or like us on Facebook at facebook.com/Captain America. You just saw a shot of the carpet, still pretty full. As you can see, nighttime is beginning to fall, so it's getting a little bit dark out here. Everyone's getting very excited to go inside to the theater. Oh, I can hear shouts, so I think there are a couple more people who are walking down the carpet. Making their way in, and we are looking very forward to seeing what the reactions to this movie are going to be. And we want to thank you guys for tuning into the broadcast, for hearing everybody talk. We know that this film is not going to disappoint. The Russo brothers talked about, you know, what it was like going home to Cleveland to shoot. It was really cool getting to hear them talk about, you know, shooting in their hometown and being able to bring this big movie back to their hometown experience. Yes, you can hear the screams. Everybody is gathering. So very soon we will show you the entire cast. And one of the things that we've been really excited about for this film is seeing the different relationships between Fury and Captain America. And we're going to show you soon, you know, some of the highlights that we've seen here tonight on the red carpet. We've had some incredible looks. So we'll show you soon so you can see, you know, who's been wearing what, who looks who. And we look forward to seeing that. All right. If we head down there, you know, this carpet is almost wrapped up. There's Sam Jackson. You see him taking a little selfie. Everybody very busy signing autographs. Some, it almost looks like there's a vintage Captain America poster there. Excited to be here with Neil McDonough. Neil, come on over. You may remember him, one of our favorite Howling Commandos.
Hi, how are you?
Great. How is it to be here tonight?
Oh, it's great fun. It's you know, the Marvel Universe has been so great to so many actors and so many creative people. It's, you know, and to be here for Captain America Part 2 is just, oh, it's just an awesome night.
Yeah, and tell me who you're here with.
This is my wife, Reve. We're about to have baby number 5, so we came out to, hopefully it's not on the red carpet tonight.
Well, you look absolutely fantastic.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, you're welcome. So what's it like being on this carpet for the second Captain America movie?
It, like I was saying, it's, you know, the great thing about Marvel is that they put their money where their mouth is. They put so much work and time and effort into each and every one of their films, and that's why they've done so very well. And you know, what Kevin and the whole company has done, it's truly amazing, and Disney backing them 100%. It's, you know, it's great to be part of them.
And one of the things we get to see in this movie, there's a Smithsonian exhibit that features the Howling Commandos. Have you seen that? Have you heard anything about that yet, or is this all going to be new to you tonight?
No, I've heard about it. I'm looking forward to seeing it tonight. It'll be a lot of fun.
Got it. Now, if you, we meet a new hero in this, we meet the Falcon. If you could have Falcon's wings or Cap's shield, which would you choose?
I think Cap's shield. I mean, Cap's shield is pretty amazing. I mean, it's, you know, especially what they do in, you know, Cap 1, what they do with his shield and in the Avengers and everything else. It's, you know, it's really truly amazing. And what Chris has done with the character is just off the page. I mean, he's such a great actor, and everyone forgets because he's such a good looking guy and such a cool guy. But he really is such an amazing, talented man. And you know, there's no one on this earth who could play Captain America like Chris Evans.
He does a great job. What about you? Are you going for wings, or are you going for the shield?
wings
Dum-dum
are...
Dum-dum Dugan. That's all right. All the way. That stash.
I paid her to say that,
man,
by the way.
Oh, man, yeah. When you shave that mustache, you go pregnant, right?
That's right,
yeah.
Exactly.
So that's what happens when
she
you shave your mustache.
She wouldn't kiss me for 6 months. You know? It was the ultimate form of contraception. Literally, I'm not kidding you.
So wait, so that beard, that was all you?
That was all me. It was, yeah.
That is very impressive.
To my wife's regret, yes, that mustache was all me.
Got it. So are you planning on naming after any particular superhero character?
Yeah, Cadillac.
Cadillac. Even the cameraman laughed at that one. I like that. Cadillac McDonough. They've been very good to me also.
Nice. Very, very nice.
Well, have a great night. And everyone in the Marvel Universe out there, thanks for letting me part of it, and enjoy the movie tonight.
All right. Enjoy yourselves tonight. I think you're in for a big
Thank
treat.
You. God bless.
And
Thank
congratulations.
You.
Good luck.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. All right, as we've talked about, the Marvel Universe, the players all show up to support one another. So you may remember Neil, he was Dum-Dum Dugan in the original, in Captain America, the first Avenger. We talked with him on the carpet here, and actually when we did the premiere for Captain America, the first Avenger, it was pretty cool. They happened, all the Howling Commandos happened to show up at the same time, and they all broke out into a little dance behind me on the camera, on the carpet. So that was very, very exciting. We were talking a little bit about Cap's shield. One of the cool things about this movie is you actually get to see the shield used defensively, like we've seen it so many times, but offensively. They really do a fantastic job of using it as an offensive weapon. I cannot even imagine the arm workout that Chris Evans had to go through to do that, to be able to flick that thing, but it's pretty amazing seeing what it does. So I'm not surprised that Neil chose to have the shield as his weapon of choice. You know, something else people have been talking a little bit about is Bucky's arm versus Nick Fury's eye patch. So curious listeners, if you know, you're able to comment on Twitter, we'd love to know, which would you choose? Would you choose Winter Soldier's arm, or would you choose the eye patch? Which is the cooler accessory if you had your choice? We are very happy to be able to talk to all of them, and to you, we want to again thank Yahoo and Zing Revolution. We are getting ready for the big intro, the big reveal of the entire cast. This is the first time they will have all been together since the movie, and they're going to be introduced on the big stage before they all go into the El Capitan Theater to watch the movie for the first time. A reminder, it opens on April 4th in the United States. It opens internationally. The rollout begins on March 26th, so you're going to want to check your local listings to see where it is playing near you. Now, one of the things that we are looking very much forward to is the fan reaction, of course, to all of the conspiracy and the intrigue that happens in this film. You've heard all the actors talk about what it was like inhabiting a world that was so gray, where you really don't know who to trust, you really don't know who is your friends, you really don't know who's not. So, you know, we'll be curious to see how everybody reacts to that. It's a very gritty Captain America movie, a very gritty, realistic feeling movie that has a lot of relevance for today. And that's something that I think is really going to resonate with a lot of people watching it, whether, you know, you're a traditional superhero fan or, you know, you're a little bit new to the Marvel franchise. And of course, this movie does really act as the bridge for Avengers Age of Ultron coming out next summer. And beyond that, we have lots of other movies to look forward to in the Marvel Universe. Of course, Guardians of the Galaxy is going to be opening up this summer, August 1st, 2014. Then, of course, we get The Avengers Age of Ultron on May 1st, 2015, followed by Ant-Man, directed by Edgar Wright, starring Paul Rudd and Michael Douglas. That will be opening in July of 2015. So fans, you guys have a lot to look forward to. And of course, as we were talking with the producers about before, in between now and then, you've got a whole bunch of episodes of Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. So there's no shortage of the Marvel Universe coming your way. There's also no shortage of actors here tonight. We are getting ready for them to introduce themselves. Just to give you an idea of what's going on here on Hollywood Boulevard, the actors are making their way down the red carpet. They're talking to some of the other outlets that are here because, of course, everybody wants to know what's going on in their minds as they're getting ready to see the movie for the first time. And then they're all going to unite at the end, and we will see the full cast together for the very first time. It's pretty exciting. It's getting dark. It's starting to get a little bit chilly, and that is okay. That is all right because everyone has banded together for this premiere. So, if you are watching, then we would love to know who you were most excited to see tonight, whose interview you were very happy to hear from, and what surprised you the most about what they said. You may be able to even hear some clanking going on. Behind me, people are starting to shift attention down to the stage at the end. Andrea is actually going to be introducing the cast, so they have brought her there. And again, a reminder to stay around until the very end. After the cast has been introduced, we are going to show you an exclusive clip from Captain America, The Winter Soldier. And I know you won't want to miss that. Marvel, of course, known for putting a little pleasant surprise for you guys at the end of all of their movies. If you do want to join in on the conversation, let us know. You can hashtag world, Cap World Premiere. Again, that's hashtag Cap World Premiere. Of course, you can follow all things Captain America at the official Twitter handle at Captain America, or like us on Facebook, facebook.com/Captain America. Marvel always makes sure that there is something special for the fans going on the web. So we are, I don't know if you can hear that, but the fans are stopped. There's a tour bus that has stopped over there, and the bus has stopped, it's parked itself right in the middle of Hollywood Boulevard. I'm not exactly sure how they got through all the barracks, and they are waiting to see the cast line up. If you haven't been to town, if you haven't ever been at a big premiere before, they block off the entire street with stanchions, and so you really can't get through. It's very obvious that there's something big going on, and clearly they are starting to see people premiere because there's a lot of screaming going on. Of course, the women in the film, I have to say, looked incredible. Yeah, there's the tour bus. See? Take a look at that. So these people have definitely gotten a nice surprise here on Hollywood Boulevard. They stumbled into the premiere of Captain America. What a great way to visit Hollywood. They are waiting for all the stars to get together. Takes a little bit of time, and we are ready for the big intro. Andrea's going to introduce the cast. We cannot wait to see what happens with them all on stage together for the first time since the film has been shot. So I can hear the music starting. Here we go. Andrea, over to you.
Are you ready? All righty. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us for the world premiere of Marvel's Captain America, The Winter Soldier. We really appreciate all your support. Are you guys ready to meet the cast? Yeah. All right. Please welcome the president of Marvel Studios and the producer of Marvel's Captain America, The Winter Soldier, Kevin Feige. Co-president of Marvel Studios and the executive producer of Marvel's Captain America, The Winter Soldier, Luis de Esposito. He's one half of the directing team, Anthony Russo. His brother, also the director, Joe Russo. She plays Peggy Carter, Haley Atwell. Here is Jack Rollins, Callan Mulvey. Here is
Trevor Sidwell, Maximiliano Hernandez. She is Maria Hill, Colby Smulders. As Brock Rumlow, Frank Grillo. Playing Agent 13, Emily Van Camp. He portrays the Winter Soldier, Sebastian Stan. He plays the Falcon, Anthony Mackie. Here is Nick Fury, Samuel L. Jackson. She is Black Widow, Scarlett Johansson. And here is Captain America, Chris Evans! Ladies and gentlemen, the cast of Marvel's Captain America, the Winter Soldier.
I'm Tamara Krinsky with Marvel Live. You have been watching the world premiere of Captain America, The Winter Soldier, brought to you by Zing Revolution, streaming on Yahoo. We want to thank you guys so much for joining us here tonight. It has been a blast talking with everyone, and more importantly, bringing it straight to you, the Marvel fans. Marvel is so, so thankful for having such an incredible group of fans, and this movie will not disappoint you. Remember, opening April 4th in theaters across the United States. Check your local listings if you are watching outside of the United States. Everyone, have a great evening tonight, and thanks again for joining us. I'm Tamara Krinsky, signing off from Marvel Live. Marvel, your universe.
Ladies and gentlemen, hi. I'm Cameron Maslavi Jones, the official teen spokesperson for Zing Revolution. What if you could actually be in the comics? Now you can. Zing Revolution and Marvel Comics invite you to crash the comics, save the universe. Go to zingrevolution.com/marvel to learn more. Crash the comics, save the universe. Go to zingrevolution.com/marvel to learn more.
Hey, Cap. How do we know the good guys from the bad guys?
If they're shooting at you, they're bad.
Ow! Whoa!
Hey, Cap! I found those bad guys you were talking about.
You okay?
I'm not dead yet.